She's not what you'd expect. She's tough and feisty, but gentle and tender. She makes millions and gives millions to the poor. She cries, she laughs, she teaches, she comforts. This is the Dani Johnson Show.
Welcome to the Dani Johnson Show. We're so very blessed that you decided to join us today. Today is going to be a day that could change your financial future. Yes, we're going to talk about money, obviously. You see, if you don't tell money where to go, it will be called by other people. It will absolutely even be stolen from. In fact, you might be having money stolen from your bank account right now, and you might not even know it. You see, the 2% of the population who is financially independent, they watch their penny, nickels, and dimes. But 98% of the population has no idea where their money is going. Money is an important thing to get an understanding of, but it's not supposed to be your God. It's not supposed to be the thing that drives you out of bed. It should not be the thing that drives you away from home 100 hours a week. But it is something that is important to have wisdom with. And so here today on the Dani Johnson Show, because money is a part of success, whether it is too much or too little, money is a part of success. It doesn't have to be the thing that you know, you make millions of dollars or billions of dollars that determines success. Not at all. In fact, it's not how much you make. It's how much you keep that determines whether or not you become financially free. And our goal here at DaniJohnson.com is to make sure you are financially free. That doesn't mean rich. That means financially free. Now, for some people, they'll become very, very, very wealthy because that's what they want to do. And for others, they could care less about becoming wealthy. Wealth has some pressure to it. It does. And so does poverty. Both has pressure. I'd rather have the other than having nothing. And basically, I mean, if you've watched the show a couple of times, you obviously have heard that all the proceeds from the show, all the profits from any business that I have goes straight to taking care of the poor, and I don't take a salary. I don't want a salary. I love to live simple. I don't want the financial pressure of managing all that money. I much rather give it to those who are actually need. Hopefully, one day you'll join us on that. So today, we are going to help you budget. Yes, we're going to help you budget your money so that you can become financially independent. And that you will not be a burden on society, but that you'll be somebody that is successful. And maybe you can lead and teach other people how to do the same exact thing. So, do you budget? That's a question I have. Let's talk about that. Do you have a budget? Do you stick to that budget? How did you create this budget? Have you ever tried to budget? What were the downfalls of it? And have you had success with budgeting? So we want to hear your secrets. And if you have any questions about doing that, we're here available for you to get the advice it is that you need so that you can succeed financially. We have Tanya Phelps from Roseburg, Oregon. I know exactly where that's at. Hi, Tanya. How are you?
Hi, Dani. It's Twana.
Twana, sorry.
That's okay, hon.
Okay, so Roseburg, Oregon has got to be gorgeous right about right now. Absolutely.
It is gorgeous. In fact, I'm sitting in front of a duck pond watching all the little pigeons and ducks in front of the pond. It's
See,
great.
That to me is success. That right there is success. Okay, so what about you? Do you budget? Do you have success budgeting?
I have been a really great at creating budgets since my husband and I got married 15 years ago. Uh-huh. I have literally spiral notebooks that I'll come across that have budgets with our income expectations and what's supposed to be going out. The problem isn't necessarily me getting it down on paper. The problem is actually following through and holding ourselves accountable because things come up. We're just like, oh my gosh, we both worked late tonight and the kids are hungry, so we better just grab something quick to eat. Or volleyball practice went over and now it's 8 o'clock and we haven't seen our house since 7 this morning. Mm-hmm. So now we got to feed everybody really fast.
Okay, hold on. This is so simple. Let me ask you a question. Do you really want to become financially independent?
I do.
Okay, stop right there. Because there was a but in the next word you were about to say. I do, but.
Yes.
Yeah.
But for some reason, it will be like I get distracted.
Hold on. You're giving me a bunch of lame excuses, number one. Number two, are you really willing to give up on the goal of being financially independent for reactive conveniences that are expenses? expensive?
Well, apparently I am.
You are. And you're going to have to come to a place, I hate to tell you this, but you're going to actually have to fall into financial ruin before you get the lesson. Or you can willingly follow the natural laws of finances that will help you to succeed, give you peace of mind, and help you be one that is not begging or borrowing, but one that actually can be the lender. Now, what you've just explained to me is two simple things. Girlfriend, you got to plan ahead. So guess what's in my kitchen right now?
I don't know.
A crock pot with 4 chicken thighs in it covered in Mexican spices. Because that's dinner. I did it this morning. Knowing that I'm going to leave my office around 5, go have a gorgeous rendezvous with that hot man that I get to live with for the rest of my life. I've joined him in this new adventure. He loves to work out. I hate it, but I want to spend more time with him, so I'm joining him on that. We're not going to get home till 7 o'clock. And then I'm going to have to take a shower because we'll be covered in sweat. So yeah, dinner's going to be served late, but it's going to be served at our house. And so what did I do? I already planned in advance. It's already in the crock pot. It is waiting for us. So as soon as we get out of the shower, we'll be eating because I plan in advance. Guess what else is in the kitchen? Is leftover beans from the last crock pot that I made these beans with because Monday night we worked out. And so I know that on the days that, for example, volleyball practice isn't every day, or if it is, then that means that there needs to be 15 minutes set apart in the morning where you're filling a crock pot with food. Or you use a day on your weekends to make a lot of food in advance, make 2 big meals that you alternate as leftovers that get heated up in a toaster oven. It takes 15 minutes to heat it up in the toaster oven while the kids are walking in the door, putting away their volleyball gear or their dance gear or whatever their gear is, so that you're heating it up, done, 15 minutes you're eating. Because let's look at the reality. So are you saying that you drive through? You drive your family through a drive-through to eat whenever you work late or the volleyball practice went late?
Sometimes, yeah.
Yeah, so we're going to put poison in our kids' bodies.
Right.
That causes health problems in the future. That is 5 times more expensive than making a meal at home. And that meal at home is healthy. So you're saying you hate your children because you're putting poison in their body. I wouldn't be laughing at that, honey, because that's a reality. You're putting poison in their body.
Yeah.
And you're doing it weekly. And that's way out of budget. So all it is 15 minutes in the morning. That's all it is.
Yeah.
15 minutes in the morning. So you know the days where there's volleyball practice, right? And you have leftovers in the fridge from days before. And that's what you pull out and put together. And I like to repurpose leftovers, right? So Monday I made this big pot of beans on purpose, twice as much than what I needed. On purpose. Well, guess what? We ate more than we were supposed to that first night. So now all I have is beans left over for a side dish. I don't have beans as a main dish this time. So last night I took out some chicken, thawed it out, and had it purpose. It didn't even take 5 minutes to do it, to be honest with you. It wasn't even 5 minutes. And I was running a little bit behind. But still, just threw it in, spiced it, turned it on low, bam, when we go to eat at 7 o'clock tonight, dinner's ready. It's gonna take 15 minutes to heat the beans up. Takes 5 minutes to take fresh vegetables out of the fridge, throw them on in a pan with a little bit of olive oil and salt. There's your veggies. Done. Fresh. Yeah. Everything's fresh and healthy.
Yeah.
Okay, now if it's drive through, the other times are going to a restaurant, right?
Yes.
Yeah. And that takes much longer to get the food than 15 minutes walking in the door.
Yeah.
Yeah. So it's important when it comes to budgeting. I love you. You said, I'm great at writing it down. I know it makes you feel good. But if you really, really look at what your actions are and the results of your actions, A, poisoning your kids' bodies. That one's heavy.
Yeah.
Poisoning weekly their bodies, especially after sports. No nutrition is going in their bodies through that fast food. Listen. Once in a great while, no problem. Weekly, monthly, big problem. So poisoning their bodies. Their bodies are built on food. Do you know that?
Yeah.
Their bodies are built on food. So the building blocks of what you're putting in their bodies is poison. Completely cancels all the good stuff that you do the other days of the week. All because we don't want to plan? All because we don't want to put some meat in a crock pot? When you're hungry, everything tastes good. I don't know if you realize that.
That's true.
It's very true. Everything tastes tastes good when you're hungry. So crock pots are so awesome. Slow cookers are amazing. Rice cookers. You can use a rice cooker. You can make risotto in the morning. Let it just cook. It stays on warm. Bam. You get in the door, scoop it on the plate. 5 minutes, man. You take some green beans right out of the fridge. You take some broccoli right out of the fridge. Cut it up. 2 minutes to do that. Throw it in that pan. 3 minutes later, it's done. Al dente, perfect, filled with nutrition. Okay? So part of budgeting, and I love that you make one, but the other part is following it through. And when you say, oh, but I don't, look at what you are doing and what's the result of it. So let's go one step further. The second thing that's going on is you're spending your kids' college tuition on fast food. You're spending the family's long-awaited vacation to some exotic place on fast food. You're setting yourself up for those things that happen, that come up, and you're not going to have the money to pay for the, whoops, how did that happen? Right?
Right.
That hurts the family. You're the mom of the household. You're the one that determines whether or not we go through the drive-thru.
Right.
Yeah. You're in control of the money, mama.
Yes.
You're in control of the kids' health, mama.
Yeah. And I have one more question, just a quick one. My husband, he has good intentions.
It sounds like you both do. You're in the same boat.
What's that?
It sounds like you both have good intentions and you're in the same boat. You don't follow through with them.
Right. Well, he's surrendered his debit card to me. And in this situation, I feel like I become a parent figure.
Well, as it is right now, I think you just need to worry about yourself.
Okay.
As it is right now, I think if you didn't get a whooping from me right now, there's a problem and there's another one worse coming. If you don't take heed to the gentle warning, you will take heed to the harsh one, and the harsh one's up next. And it ain't coming from me. So I don't think you should be worrying about your husband. I think you should be worrying about yourself. And you're going to save you're going to save the family at least $500 a month by not spending on fast food and not eating out just because we didn't plan. So 15 minutes in the morning, okay? And when you cook, when you have days that you get to cook, cook a lot and then repurpose that food. Make stir fry one night. You take that leftover stir fry, you throw it in with the rice and you make it fried rice the next night. It's really simple and it's a brand new fresh meal. God bless you, girl. Thanks so much for calling in. This is Dani Johnson. We'll continue after this.
How important is health insurance? What about life insurance? Coming up next, Dani will share her secrets on how to budget for insurance.
The whole story of how I went from homeless to millions is right here in this book, First Steps to Wealth. I'd love to give you a free copy of this book. Just dial 888-757-8880. You can get your free copy of this book. It's like a real book, my friend. You can get an ebook copy for free right now, or if you'd like to pay the shipping to get this $15 book to your house, I'd be happy to send it to you. 888-757-8880. Get your copy of First Steps to Wealth today and begin on a brand new path of some great success. Imagine living in a decrepit, unsafe hovel made of waste material on top of old mining tunnels that could explode and sink your home at any moment. Imagine no water to drink, no safe place to raise your children, no food for your starving baby. Imagine that your kids can't learn to read because they have to work to support the family instead of going to school. Could you imagine living in that kind of fear and hopelessness? This is exactly what families are dealing with in the poverty-stricken village of Santa Pancha, Nicaragua. These families can barely meet their basic food, water, and housing needs. We are transforming that village. Be a part of this miracle. I want you to go to the website now and learn how you can help. Go to kingsransom.org and click on Santa Pancha. There you can join with other warriors against poverty and help bring a miraculous transformation to Santa Pancha. That's kingsransom.org, kingsransom.org. This is your chance. This is your shot. Get your copy of War on Debt right now. There's one waiting for you that has your family's name on it. And inside that package is freedom, your family's freedom is on the inside of that package. All you have to do is open it up, press play, and start applying what I teach you in this program. 888-757-8880. You and I are going to help your family become completely debt-free in the next 5 to 7 years. Just imagine how that's going to feel.
This is the Dani Johnson Show.
We are in complete control of how we spend. You are and I am. And every day we make choices and every day we spend something. And either we're spending our future retirement or we're spending our long-awaited vacation on food and convenience, or we're making plans and we're budgeting. Here today on the Dani Johnson Show, we are talking about your budget. We're talking about creating one and how do we follow through with it and really looking at the full picture of every decision we make with the dollar. And so we're taking calls right now and helping people with that budget or those that are budgeting and the success that they're having. We want to hear from them as well. So we've got Amy Lee from Vancouver, Canada. Welcome to the program. Thanks for joining us, Amy.
Hi, Dani.
So what about you? Do you have a budget? Are you keeping the budget? How's that going?
Well, I started a war on debts, I think the end of summer last year.
Okay.
And we were doing really well for 4 months. And I kid you not, my income was increasing every month.
Wow.
And then we fell off the bandwagon.
You got comfortable. You started feeling good about yourself.
Increasing every month.
Wow, imagine that. Now, hold on a second, because I want to talk about that. Okay, so you said that while we were following war on debt, and we did really, really good for 4 months, your income was increasing at the same time that you were sticking to the budget and being faithful with the little things. Then you got comfortable, you started feeling good about yourself, right? And you started to lax on your self-discipline.
Yep.
And you guys started to get a little bit loose with your spending, maybe eating out more, things like that, and now your income started to decrease. So, honey, what's the question? Because it sounds to me like you know how to do it.
Yeah, no, so we're back on the bandwagon again. I got all my spreadsheet of all my numbers and all my budgeting. Mm-hmm. Now, one question I have is life insurance. So we have whole life insurance, universal life, disability. Every month we're spending $500 on life insurance.
Are you serious right now?
I know. What do I do with that?
Cancel it?
Well, it's got the investment portion to it. So what do I do with that?
Well, I have a friend that I'm going to give you his name and phone number. And I want you to call them because they really have incredible expertise with that very specific thing that you're talking about. You don't need all of those things. And so our producer, Raven, is going to give you his phone number. You're going to call him, and he's going to tell you which one to keep and which ones to get rid of, or he might tell you about something else that does it all for not $500 a month. Get that out of there. That's ridiculous, girlfriend. If you were to take that $500 a month and learn how to invest it, you would never need life insurance. Seriously.
That's exactly what I was thinking.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah. Yeah. You know, let me tell you something. My husband and I, many years ago, our insurance, just our medical insurance, was $1,200 a month for our family. And we didn't go to the doctor a single time. Not a single time. So look at that. $1,200 times 12 months is 24 what? 12 times 12? No, 144. Yes, $14,400 we spent on insurance and never went to the doctor. Guess what we did the next year? We canceled the insurance. We canceled it. We canceled it. And we have money set aside for emergencies. Like, and we never go to the doctor. None of us do. None of us ever go to the doctor. And so here paying $1,200 a month for insurance, that's like stupid. So instead we take that money, we invest into other things, grow that money versus giving it to someone else that's growing it, right? The insurance company are using the money to grow it. And then, of course, you know, insurance companies don't want to pay up when something does happen. That, they just drive me crazy. Anyway, so, yeah, I want you to call. When I put you on hold, she's going to pick up the line, and she's going to tell you who to call and get you that information immediately because that is ridiculous, $500 a month. No. Now, girl, you better stay on track. Do you hear me, young lady?
Yes, ma'am.
You will be completely debt-free in the next 5 to 7 years. You do not want to be—
4.51.
How many?
4.51.
So in less than 5 years, that's amazing, you'll be completely debt-free, including your mortgage, your cars, your everything. That's the road to financial independence. Trust me. You can be self-disciplined for that long. And then you'll be self-disciplined even beyond that because you guys will get into a millionaire status. You'll get into a place where you have no worry financially. And all it is staying focused. And you can do that. You can absolutely do that.
Gotcha.
All right. So
what would you do with home insurance?
Again, I would be assessing what the value is. How much am I paying? I would be shopping around for what is the best. If you have a mortgage, you have to have home insurance, right?
So, not in Canada.
Oh, well, then I don't know. I'd be looking. How much am I paying? What is the value? What am I getting? Is there another form that I can get that is not as expensive that covers the basics? Look at that. And how much is the value of your house versus how much is the value that you're going to pay into that insurance for how many years? Look at that. Sounds like you were a great sucker for some insurance for an insurance salesman is what that looks like to me. Someone came to your house and had a heyday with y'all selling you some fear. This is Dani Johnson. We'll continue with more right after this.
Change your habits, change your future. Stay right here for more of The Dani Johnson Show.
But I'm so blessed that I found what is in Grooming the Next Generation for Success. This is a book that is being taught in universities around the world. It's been noted as the best book on parenting that has ever been written. Crazy, if you ask me. But the point is that this thing gets results. Get your copy today, 888-757-8880. Again, that's 888-757-8880. Or go to DaniJohnson.com. That's DaniJohnson.com. Get your copy today.
Hello, my name is Michael Park and I'm from London, England. Prior to plugging into DaniJohnson.com, I knew where I wanted to go in life, but I didn't have the skills to get me there. Since coming to First Steps to Success about 10 weeks ago, I've paid off more than $2,500 in debt. I've increased my income and I've learned skills that will just take me through for the rest of my life. I can't recommend it highly enough that you plug into First Step to Success and get yourself here.
Prior to getting started with DaniJohnson.com and First Steps to Success, we were spending absolutely every dime that we made. We were really struggling financially. Since plugging in to First Steps to Success just 4 months ago, we started a brand new business that is doing very, very well. We've paid off $4,500 in debt, but the most important thing is my relationship with my husband has improved like dramatically. I mean, we have so much more fun together. You know, I don't know about you. Maybe your finances, you're doing great. Maybe you're debt-free. Maybe your relationships with your spouse, with your family are great. But if not, if you have some areas in your life that feel a little out of control or there's things that you need to work on, I highly recommend getting to First Steps to Success as soon as you can.
Prior to being dragged out to First Steps to Success, I was hopeless. I had no point to life. It was a day-to-day existence, working a job I despised for people I didn't respect. Deeper and deeper debt every year. You just couldn't get on top of it. I just had no hopes or dreams, none at all, and there was no point to life. But since coming out, we paid off $280,000 worth of debt, married the woman of my dreams. I came to love my job and the people I work for. I have all kinds of hopes and dreams. I get to watch them happen every day. I don't know what your life is like, you know? There's probably tons of hope. You probably know why you live and you got places you're going, but if you don't, you need to sign up for First Steps to Success. You go to DaniJohnson.com and you click on it and be here because your life will not be the same if you do.
Prior to First Steps to Success, I was drowning in debt. I was terrified of my bills and I wanted to travel, but I never had the money. And since coming to First Steps to Success in the last 14 months, I've paid off over $18,000 in debt. I've gone on 6 vacations and I'm not terrified of my bills anymore. So if you want to learn some proven strategies to really learn how to connect with people, take your life to the next level, all while having a total blast, you need to get registered for the next First Steps to Success today.
Prior to coming to First Steps to Success, we were totally struggling, totally under the weight of $640,000 worth of debt, making $20,000 a month, but living paycheck to paycheck. So when we came here and I realized that it takes a totally different skill set to keep money, to create wealth than there is to make money, I have totally turned around our lifestyle. We have paid off $640,000 worth of debt in 2 years. We are debt-free as of June of 2013. I don't know where you're at. You might have all your finances in order. You might have a wonderful life. Your marriage might be all perfect and your kids are behaving. But if not, if one of those things is lacking, you gotta get here. Book your next event. You need to be here. You will not regret it.
And now, back to the Dani Johnson Show.
Budgeting is not a prison. It's not at all. It helps you to set priorities for your money so that you're leading what matters to you. Okay, that's what you're walking in. You're leading financially with what matters to you instead of being pulled in every possible direction. Without a financial vision, you will come to financial destruction. A man without a vision will perish. Well, if a man without a financial vision, his finances will perish. And they will. I mean, we live in a very marketing savvy culture. Oh gosh, a very marketing savvy world. It is so easy to end up on a website that says free shipping. I'm talking from personal experience. Free shipping, right? And have all these amazing things that, oh, I need. And you don't need any of it. But we can get pulled in because we don't have a financial vision. And without a financial vision, somebody else's financial vision is going to supersede ours and take our finances straight out of our bank account and put it into theirs. And they are going to have success with your money instead of you having success with your money. We're talking about budgeting. We are helping you today to do some budgeting, get serious about your finances, and or hearing from the people who are budgeting and or need help in that area. So we're answering questions and as well as hearing input from our faithful listeners to The Dani Johnson Show. Jordan James from Houston, Texas. Jordan, welcome to The Dani Johnson Show.
Hi, Dani.
Hi. So do you budget?
I do my best.
Oh.
I'm still, you know, getting the hang of it.
Uh-huh.
But here's my question. A little short backstory. I am a single mom, and I am still in the beginning stages of my business.
Okay.
So my income hasn't been consistent at this point.
Mm-hmm.
And I was just wondering if you had any advice on creating a budget with non-consistent income.
I would go get consistent income immediately.
Okay.
There you go. I would not try to force your business to yield you full-time income that is going to provide for you and your children. I wouldn't put that pressure on myself to make that happen overnight. You got kids to feed, and every month that goes by that your income is not being able to pay for that, you're gonna end up quitting your business altogether if you do not set yourself up to succeed. So I would hire a boss, and I would get a consistent income, work your business on the side until it gets to a point where it is taking care of more than your needs. You got to get that thing profitable, and you can't put mm-hmm. yourself under pressure like that. So that's the first thing I would do is I would get a solid income immediately. Number two is that, okay, there's lots of people who come from businesses that their business, for example, is seasonal. So they have months where there's just tons of flourishing, and then they have other months where it is like a famine. Okay. Construction's mm-hmm. a prime example. Roofing. It depends on where in the country you live, but obviously Upper East Coast, they get snow, they get sleet, they get rain. There's several months out of the year where they cannot come out of the house and go work on someone's roof. But, you know, for 4 months of the year or 5 months of the year, bam, you know, it's really tough. So it's really flourishing. It's crazy busy. So what I teach people in that field to do is that you got to average your income throughout the whole year. I mean, you have years of proof of how much income that you are used to making. In your case, you have a brand new business, so you don't know, right? So you basically cause yourself to live on the least every month.
Mm-hmm.
So let's say that you have a month that you make $5,000 and the next month you make $2,000, right?
Right.
And that seems to be the average. Like your low, whatever your low is what you got to force yourself to live on all the time. And right. Even when that business grows into hundreds of thousands, still live on the low. Do not grow your lifestyle with your first year of a flourishing year, because you have no idea what next year is going to look like. You have no idea what the year after that is going to look like. And that's the biggest mistake rookie entrepreneurs make, is that, oh, it's my first time being in business. And, you know, when you have a good year, you think, oh, I mean, it's going to be the same next year. No, it's not going to be the same next year. It could be worse. It could be better. And so, but if you budget yourself and you limit yourself to living on the low, and even when your income grows, you still live on the low, now you have a fat bank account. now you're developing a bank account with lots of reserves in there. You know what I mean? And at that point, once you have now a couple of years under your belt with a good consistent income, you now have a new low. But I wouldn't say go from the low to now a high low. Be very, very, I mean, my husband and I have refused to go hog wild when our income went hog wild. We did that in our first 10 years of business. We went absolutely nuts, right? So we made a ton of money. We spent a ton of money. And then guess what we had left over the next year? Nothing. And boy, did it hurt us big time. So when we started some other businesses, it was like, no, we're going to keep our lifestyle really super low. So all this money is going to go towards investing and giving to the poor, of course. But we're going to keep a lot of reserves and cause that money to give birth and to grow more so that our money is working for us and we're not working for it. So we have refused that when we went from, you know, making, less than $100,000 a year at one point to making millions of dollars a year, we did not raise our lifestyle to millions of dollars a year. We have still kept a very modest mid-range, middle-class lifestyle, not high-end middle-class at all. So we've kept it around just around the same kind of lifestyle that we had before. So that would be my recommendation, is always use the low number. Don't use your high number. Always use the low number to base it on. And if the low number is not enough to provide for your family, you need to supplement your income. And I would get a consistent full-time income or whatever it is that you need to help provide for your family so you take that pressure off yourself. And then that way, your business is a lot of bonus money. So.
Awesome.
All right. I'm excited for you. I can't wait to hear what you do with that. Yeah. Does that feel better?
Yes.
Does that take some pressure off?
It's kind of something I've been thinking I needed to do. Mm-hmm. So you just confirmed it.
That's so awesome. That's really, really awesome. Have you got the book First Steps to Wealth?
Yes, I do.
Okay, that's awesome because there's two chapters in there about an employeepreneur. Really important to practice those with whoever it is that you're going to go in partnership with for a full-time income. Do you own Job Domination?
Yes.
Good job. So I want you to start watching that today. Okay, watch that today. And then get out there and do everything that it says on that part one about finding that job. And then part two is how you're going to work in that position because doors are going to fly open for you. You're going to practice those entrepreneurial skills at the job. And then when you go to build your business, it's not abnormal. It's not unnatural. It's very natural because it's all the same mindset. It's all the same skills. Everything's the same. It'll be an easy transition, not a foreign transition. So I'm excited for you. I can't wait to hear what you do, Jordan. Thanks so much
for calling.
I appreciate you. Yeah. Okay. So then we've got Lauren Moffitt from Atlanta, Georgia. Lauren, welcome. What can I do for you?
Hi, Dani.
What can we do for you?
I had a question about breaking up your budget into percentages. Like, what is the recommended or the wisest percentage for breaking up from your state? Like, what you put for savings, fun, business, living expenses? Like, how would you break that up while you're paying off debt?
Okay. So let me ask you this. How much are you spending in those directions already now?
I don't know.
Ooh, you just told me something. You just said a mouthful. You just said an enormous mouthful. Do you have war on debt?
Yeah.
Oh, here comes my belt. Bend over, honey. I'm gonna beat you. This mama is gonna give you a mama beating right now. You have war on debt, and you do not know the answer to the question of how much you are spending on those other items. You were just asking me how much you should be spending on those other items.
I don't know because my husband does all the.
Oh, did you just give me the husband excuse? You said, Lauren, did you really just give me the husband excuse? Girl,
right here, I can ask.
You are asking for a second beating right now. Oh, whoa. Okay. Have you taken the package off of War on Debt, the plastic?
Yes.
Have you watched it?
Yes.
Have you gone through the workbook?
Yes.
And how much debt have you paid off?
Over
$60,000. Oh, girlfriend! Okay, I'm not going to beat you anymore. You've paid off $60,000 worth of debt?
Yes.
I'm so proud of you. Okay, now hold on. How fast did you pay off that $60,000 worth of debt?
Since we started in February 2014.
Okay, so wow. So in less than 2 years, you have paid off $60,000 worth of debt.
Yeah.
Okay, I want you to take your hand. I want you to take your hand. I want you to reach behind your head right now and pat yourself on the back. And then if your husband is standing right there, you need to give him a big wet kiss from Dani on his cheek.
Big kiss from Dani.
Kiss from Dani. I am so proud of the two of you. I really am. I'm so very proud of the two of you. Okay,
Thank
now listen.
You.
As we cut, we have to go to a quick break. When I come back, I want you to ask him, okay, does he know what those numbers actually are? Okay, so that we can see and hopefully I can help and we'll go from there. This is Dani Johnson. We'll continue with more after this. Can you believe that? They paid off $60,000 of debt in less than 2 years. I love you.
Coming up next, Dani used to spend $25,000 a month on shopping and entertainment. Find out how she got it down to $100 a month and how it changed her life.
Are you kidding me?
The whole story of how I went from homeless to millions is right here in this book, First Steps to Wealth. I'd love to give you a free copy of this book. Just dial 888-757-8880. You can get your free copy of this book. It's like a real book, my friend. You can get an ebook copy for free right now, or if you'd like to pay the shipping to get this $15 book to your house, I'd be happy to send it to you. 888-757-8880. Get your copy of First Steps to Wealth today and begin on a brand new path of some great success.
My name's Derek, and this is my wife, Michelle, and we're the Hollinshits. We live in Covina, California, about 45 minutes from here, and we're extremely honored to be able to share our story. And when we were approached about it, I was kind of thinking, well, where do I start? Where do we start? But I'm going to start a few years back before there was a Michelle and Derek. I was actually debt free, you know, and kind of going along pretty good. And then a funny thing happened. I got married and I married into debt. We're going to do fine. We'll pay it off and life will be good. But a funny thing happened was that didn't seem to happen.
As a result, just kind of thinking it's going to happen. Well, we're going to do this, we're going to do that, and something always happens, and the result is that, you know, debt doesn't get paid. So, you know, it starts becoming like an old friend. And then, unfortunately, the marriage failed, but I was able to meet Michelle, and, we got married. And, married into debt again. only now it's a little bit bigger, but at least the house that I had, this was during the housing boom, so use some of the equity in the house to, pay that debt off. And we got a clean state, let's go forward. In our early days in our marriage, we had some difficulty as far as being on the same page financially, and Michelle will share a little bit more about that. And I guess it's a good point for me to hand it over to her.
Hello, everybody. Good morning. Like Derek said, honestly, you guys, the first 7 years of our marriage, when I came into our marriage, he paid my debt off. And I ran our debt up 3 different times in the first 7 years of our marriage, you guys. I would have never imagined being in that spot. Derek didn't trust me. And I finally got to a place where, my gosh, I can't keep doing this. I was pretty much told to come to this event by a good friend of mine, and it was the best thing she could have said to me, because it's what I needed. I would have not have come had I not have had that charge and challenge that way. The moment I got here, and we saw the war, I saw the war on debt. I said, this is it. This is our ticket. This is what's going to help us go to the next level. This is what's going to help us. You guys, in 33 months, we have paid off over $159,000 worth of debt. We have money in savings. We have $300,000, $300,000 in assets, income-producing assets. We continue to plug in. I was the first one to come, but immediately afterwards, I told my husband I couldn't wait. I called him. I told him about War on Debt. He immediately said, let's do it. We had some friends that hosted a War on Debt class there right after, and we went to it, and we found $502 worth of excess spending our first month, and we revisited our budget after that, and then we thought we were just broke, living paycheck to paycheck. We were overwhelmed. We felt hopeless. I never would have thought I would lose my husband's trust, and the techniques, the strategies that Dani Johnson teaches you guys helped us save our marriage, our finances, our communication. You guys, we started out with my favorite product is spiritual equipping, and I know Darren has a favorite product.
We're on debt, and you think?
You guys, we kind of bought things one by one. However, you guys have a great opportunity outside that door, that table out there, where you can buy the whole DJ University curriculum, and you get almost $1,000, over $1,000 off. So you have either option, but that's a great opportunity for you. Don't let anything stop you guys. There is hope, you know, there is life, and I'm very grateful and honored to be here. So, without further delay, you guys, help us welcome back America's favorite millionaire and our mentor and coach, Dani Johnson.
Straight talk, real answers. This is the Dani Johnson Show.
I'm so excited. Did you not just hear that last part? They've paid off $60,000 worth of debt in less than 2 years, but roughly about a year and a half. Wow, this is absolutely amazing. All right, so they've got a budgeting question. They're obviously wanting to go a little bit further in their education for their finances. They've not been foolish. They've not been people that have purchased War on Debt, left the plastic on. They have actually taken the plastic off. They pressed play. They went through the workbook, and they've applied some of the information that is inside of there, which is really awesome. But one of the most important things with finances is knowing where your money is going. You don't want to not know where it's going, okay? In the equation of success, especially financial success, that's just one little part of your success life is the financial part. You got to have a financial vision. And if you don't know where your money is going, then you don't know how to lead it. I promise you it's leaking to places that you just don't need it. All right, so I got Lauren Moffitt again on the phone from Georgia. I'm really so proud of you. I want to kiss you.
Mwah.
I'm just so proud of you guys, both of you, man. I would just be hugging your necks right now. Okay, so let's go ahead and restate the question again for those who have just joined us somewhere in their car. Go ahead. You want to know how much you spend on what?
Okay, I was wondering, I wanted to know the percentage of, what is the recommended or the wisest percentage to put towards, you know, savings, your fund budget, your, you know, business, living expenses, like what's the active budget, I mean, while you're paying off debt.
Okay, perfect. Well, again, what's important is that you know how much of a percentage you are doing right now. And you've managed to pay off $60,000 worth of debt, which is really awesome. But what you want to do as a general rule of thumb, and every family is different. Okay, let's talk about the fund budget. This is something that we talk about in War on Debt because you have to have some kind of a reward system for you and your husband for being good kids and paying off your debt, you know, getting yourself out of the pit that you dug yourself in. So you know my story. I used to spend $25,000 a month on fun, right? That was shopping, mostly shopping and food, you know, for myself and friends and traveling to go shop. I mean, this was like complete stupidity. So when I got this conviction that greed had been controlling my life and I was being led by money instead of being led by purpose, I cut myself off from $25,000 a month and I gave myself $100 a month for a fund budget. And that $100 could be used to go out to dinner. The $100 could be used to buy 8 pairs of shoes from Walmart, or that $100 could be used to be saved for 3 months to buy 1 pair of shoes at Nordstrom. So that what it did is it cut off, it stopped me from shopping daily or even weekly or even monthly is what happened. And so it kind of put blinders on. Like I didn't even see what was available to buy because I would have to wait to the end of the month to get my $100 reward. And that $100, then I would go, okay, how do I want to spend that? And there'd be things maybe now and again that would kind of catch my eye, but it would have to be like something I really, 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 really wanted and wanted to spend that $100 on. And so as far as a fund budget, I don't even know if you could call that a percentage. It was a 0.00%. Do you know what I mean? 0.001% of our total income was my fund budget. Does that make, I don't even know what the percentage was because, you know, $100 is very, very small. Very, very small. So, and we had a six-figure income. But that's what I did for me. And I'm going to tell you, that was really powerful for me. I learned a lot about myself and I was able, it was almost as though I was a drug addict and I dried myself up. You know what I mean? So I thought more clearly. I felt better about myself. Every single time I didn't buy something, I felt so good about myself. And the fact that I gave myself a limit and I stayed within that limit, I felt successful. I didn't feel deprived. I actually felt successful. But mind you, spending $25,000 a month never made me feel successful, ever. So as far as a budget for fun, what are you spending now on fun?
Well, I asked my husband about the percentages, and he said it's about 2%.
2% of the income is on fun budget?
Yeah.
Okay, what's the income?
Over six figures.
So you're blowing how much on fun?
$150 a month.
Okay, $150 a month you guys are each blowing on fun, so it's $300 between the two of you?
No, that's total.
That's total, $150. Okay,
so
I think...
We should have separate fun budgets.
Well, if your husband wants that. You know what happened to me, Lauren, is that it took about 8 months for me to even lose the desire to buy anything. It took 8 months. It actually didn't take 8 months. Here's what happened. It took like 3 or 4 months. Like, I went hog wild with that $100 initially. And then what happened is that I lost the desire to buy anything. I was like, I don't want anything. There was nothing that was like tantalizing me. So then I took a woman who was poor and I took her shopping and took her to lunch with the $100. So I actually gave it to someone else instead. And that was so much fun. That was so fulfilling to me. Oh my gosh, I had the best day that day. You know, she got some new jeans. We went to Ross Dress for Less. She got a couple tops and we had a little lunch together, all for $100. And that was so rewarding. And then I was like, there's nothing I want. There's nothing I want to buy. There's nothing I want to go do. And so I just started saving it. But then I was like, I want to go to Hawaii by myself. I want to leave Hans home with all these little kids and I want to go to Hawaii by myself for 2 weeks. So I started saving money for that. And then I was sitting in church one day and this you know, youth group was going to Mexico and they were short $800. And Lauren, do you know how much money I had saved in an envelope in a file for my whole trip to Hawaii?
$800. Oh.
I'd been saving for 8 months, man. I've been saving for 8 months to go to Hawaii and I'm sitting there and these kids need this. They're leaving the next day and I'm sitting there going, oh, that's just too bad. And I felt in my spirit, I felt like it was God say, you need to give them your $100. I go, devil, I rebuke you in the name of Jesus. Go to hell. We are in church. You ain't supposed to be here. And he said, this is not him, but you're going to give those kids your $800. I'm like, wah! So right after church, I privately met with the youth pastor and I said, don't you dare tell a soul I did this, but here. Secretly, this is awesome. Secretly, my husband and my mother behind my back did not even know I wanted to go to Hawaii. They put up $1,000 each and sent me for 2 weeks.
Oh, wow.
Yep. They had no idea I had that money. They had no idea I gave that money. They had no idea that that's what I was saving for. But they thought, you know what? She's worked so hard with the kids and I was taking care of my mother. And so they both sent me away. So, fun budget. Yeah, I think 150, I think you guys are doing great there. All right, savings. So I don't know if you know this, but 70%, if you can make yourself live on 70% or less of your income, put 10% towards savings, 10% towards debt, and 10% towards giving. Okay, so that should give you your percentages. Do that. If you can do less than 70%, which I know that you could if you guys make six figures, if you can do less than 70%, then do less. Okay, so 10% for giving, 10% for savings, 10% for, what did I say? Crap, it just flew out of my head.
You said 10% debt, 10% yes. Savings, the 150 for fun.
And 10% for giving. Give 10% for giving, 10% for savings, 10% for debt, and live off of 70%. But like I said, because you guys make a lot of money, you should be able to do it even less than that. Like, look to see if you can reduce it even from there, and I would put more towards debt. Get out of debt. Because, again, you're paying a percentage of the debt, 18.9% on those credit cards. You're paying interest. I'd much rather you save that interest by getting rid of the debt, and then now you'll have so much more to put towards savings and then learn to start investing. Such a great question. I really, really appreciate the question. And I'm proud of you guys.
Well, thank you.
I'm so proud of you. Keep on keeping on, Mama. You're going to be debt free. I'm so excited.
Woohoo!
Woohoo! This is Dani Johnson. We'll continue with more right after this.
Don't go away. The next segment might just change your life. This is the Dani Johnson Show.
For families in Santa Pancha, Nicaragua, life is filled with fear and struggle. They don't have enough food for their kids, clean water is hard to find, and they're living in a decrepit, unsafe hovel on top of mining tunnels that could explode and sink at any moment. But a miracle is in the making, and you can be a part of transforming this village. Go to kingsransom.org and click on Santa Pancha to see how you can help. That's kingsransom.org, kingsransom.org, and click on Santa Pancha. I just heard this amazing story. One of our clients had written us telling us that they had used job domination and unlimited success and has absolutely exploded their career. He said, Dani, I don't know where I'd be today without job domination and unlimited success. Listen, do you want more recognition from your coworkers? Do you want to be recommended to people all over the world? Do you want to be somebody that is highly sought after? Listen, if you're in a dead-end place where this gentleman found himself but then learned new strategies and changed everything in his work life, and obviously this has resulted in higher bonuses and pay raises, you're next. 888-757-8880. Get your copy of Job Domination right now. 888-757-8880. Again, 888-757-8880. Job domination. That's what you need. It's time for you to dominate the job market and break through the rut that you're in.
My name is Mario Johns. I'm from Scranton, Pennsylvania. And I just want to share with you on April 14, 2013, that was the first day I heard the name Dani Johnson. And I was so inspired by her story, and I just had to find out, you know, how did she go from homeless to millionaire? And it was just so inspiring to me. So I went on DaniJohnson.com, and I started getting the daily emails, the daily fixes, and then after a while, I just stopped reading them for some reason. And August of 2013, it was 4 days before my first event. After work, I went on YouTube, and I typed in Dani Johnson's name came to my mind, so I typed it in on YouTube, and I sat at my kitchen table for about an hour and just listened to testimonial after testimonial, and I was just so inspired. I'm like, I have to get to this first steps to success. And I had no money. I didn't know how I was gonna get there. The funny thing was, a week prior to this day, I got a credit card in the mail that I never asked for. It was a $1,200 credit limit. I was gonna cut it up, but I figured I'd save it for like the emergency. I got my event ticket, my flight, and my hotel room. I maxed that sucker out, and I came down to Dallas, Texas. And the first 3 hours of the first day, I was just like in tears the whole time. I was just so blown away. It was something that I was just so hungry for. And prior to plugging in, I was a depressed, hopeless, suicidal drug addict. I hated myself, I hated life, I hated other people. I felt like a slave to debt, and I actually accepted debt as part of my life. I had toxic relationships, and I was, and then since plugging in, I've been drug-free for 15 and a half months now. I paid off over $13,000 worth of debt in a little over 13 months. I've completely restored my relationships with my family, my friends. I have amazing friends today from around the world. I love my life, and this is just an honor to be up on this stage. But if I just want to say, if you're new here, one thing that I wish I did is one of my favorite products is War on Debt. And I'll be honest with you, I haven't been following that as like I should be. If I got War on Debt and followed that with diligence, I'd be debt-free. So I just want to encourage you, if you're new here and you have debt, I highly recommend getting that, because that's, by the end of this year, I want to be debt-free, and that's my goal. So, please help me welcome back to the stage America's favorite millionaire, Dani Johnson.
And now, back to the Dani Johnson Show.
So you're on a road trying to budget so that you can become financially independent. You want to be completely debt-free, and yet there's somebody coming against you. That's exactly where Emily has found herself. Emily from Portland, Oregon, welcome to the show. So you've got a question.
Hi.
How do you budget when your spouse is not on board? Is that correct?
Yeah, that's my question.
I love that question. I'm going to tell you why. I had a woman by the name of Tammy. She came to me with the same thing. My husband, he won't do war on debt. My husband, again and again and again and again. And I told her, I am never going to work with you again if you use your husband as an excuse for anything. So I'm going to give you your money back on your consulting appointment right now. Either that or you're going to follow directions. Pick one. I'll follow directions. You don't need your husband to be on board, Emily. The women of the household are the big spenders of the household. We are in charge of the money. We buy the food. We pay the bills. We do all the errands. We sign up the kids for all the extracurricular things that they do not need. We're the ones who buy the clothes, unless, of course, your husband is the one that does all the school clothes shopping and all the gift shopping. And hello, are you know what I'm saying right now?
Well, he does do quite a bit of it. He's a better budgeter than I am. Mm.
Then why are you saying he's not on board?
I don't want to throw him under the bus and say he's the whole problem, because it's not.
But it's not. So that's what I'm telling you. You have to take care of the you part of the equation. You spend money every single day. You spend money every week. You spend money every month. You take care of how you're spending money, and you pay attention to using those war on debt systems. Here's what Tammy did. Tammy, without her husband, paid off $130,000 worth of debt. Without her husband.
Wow.
After she paid off the $130,000, guess what? Her husband came on board.
He was on board.
Oh, absolutely. So don't even look at what he's doing. You just need to look at what you're doing. Understood?
Okay.
And yet the results that you produce quietly, he'll get on board with you, honey. And you will be the most sexiest woman on earth to him. you'll be Wonder Woman. You'll be the most awesome person on earth for him if you do that. So you go do it. Surprise him. Go pay off $20,000 worth of debt and surprise him without him even knowing it. He will be shocked. It'll be like you're on an endless honeymoon once you do that. I know you can. I've had thousands of women do it without their husbands, and then the husbands come on board. They need results. That's the bottom line. Quit nagging, quit pointing out what he's doing, and start proving with results about how serious you are, that this is not some fad thing that you're working towards. All right, so friend, listen. You can become debt-free, and you can go and become financially independent. I promise you, it is so simple. It is so very, very simple. You've got to stay on track. Create that budget. Utilize the tools that you have available to you with War on Debt and the financial independence system that we put together for you. It's so simple, and it has to do with all the little things. It's the grocery store runs. It's the gas station runs. It's that extra blouse that you didn't need. Those are the places where your money is running away from you. You can get on track today and begin to pay off that debt and be completely debt-free. This is Dani Johnson. Thanks so much for joining us. God bless.
This has been the Dani Johnson Show. Did you hear that last segment? Do you know someone else who needs to hear it? If this episode was an encouragement to you, go to DaniJohnson.com and share it with your friends now. You never know who else needs to hear it.